Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. My name is Drago Sepina and I'm a pet portrait artist based in Belgium. In today's video I'm going to try to film a full-time tutorial, so in real life. And I'm going to do it in more parts and we're going to draw this beautiful monarch butterfly together. And I'm going to do it step by step, so no time lapse, just me talking and telling you guys what I'm doing while I'm doing it. And I would love for you guys to do the same drawing in the same time with me. And maybe let me know how your result looks like. Now I'm going to tell you guys what colors I'm going to use. I'm going to use a white color from Carandash. I'm going to use as well a dark Naples ochre from Faber-Castell Polychromos. A terracotta color from Faber-Castell Polychromos. A dark indigo color from Faber-Castell Polychromos. And as well, a black color from Faber-Castell Polychromos. You can use which brand you have, doesn't matter, as long as your colors are matching my swatches here. So please be careful which colors you are going to choose and try to match them with those from here. It is very important to choose the right colors. And I'm going to use as well some extra materials. A slice tool. A Tombow Mono Eraser and as well a white ink pen. I'm using the one from Signal. About the slice tool, I'm not sure if I'm going to use it, but in case I'm going to use it in the drawing, I wanted to let you know now so you have to prepare it. But I'm going to see in the drawing if I need it or not. But if you don't have a slice tool, you can always use a craft knife like this. They are very cheap and they work very good, so we just it's basically the same concept with the slice tool, you just need to scrape off some pigment from the paper and create highlights. Okay guys, so now without further ado, let's get into the video. And now I'm going to start out just by remodeling a bit the body of the butterfly because my sketch is not very clear and I'm following very good my reference photo. And I'm just trying to make the outline a bit more visible. It doesn't matter if it's a bit too strong. It doesn't matter if the outline is a bit too dark. We're going to cover it in black anyway. But I really want to follow my reference photo very good. And to try to render as close as possible that outline. It is very important to have a very nice and clear outline from the beginning to make your job easier in the future. And I'm following, as I said, my reference photo very good. Does have to be 100% precise. I don't want to copy paste the photo. I also want to leave a bit of place for my creativity. And to have fun as well. Okay, so I finished this part here and I'm going to try a bit on this side. It is a very small drawing, so it's going to be difficult to add a lot of details in, but I'm going to try my best. I want to make a small drawing. I didn't want it to take too much time because I want to film this in real time, and if the drawing was very big, it will take me for a lot of hours and it wouldn't be pleasant for you guys to watch my videos for hours. So that's why I'm trying to make it as fast as possible, and I want to make this as less parts as possible for you guys to be able to finish it faster as well. Make this little leg here a bit more visible. I don't want to lose that outline because if I'm going to cover it, I'm not going to be able in the end to remember that here was the leg. So I want to keep this white space here very clear. So when I come to this part, to be able to see that he rolls the legs and to work on it. I really love monarch butterflies. I always see them here in Belgium and they are very beautiful. And once, while I was walking in the forest, one of them just tapped on my shoulder and I was like very surprised that it wasn't afraid, and it was like, I tried to make a photo, but it flew away and I wasn't able, but it was a very nice feeling having a butterfly on my shoulder. And that's why I really love these butterflies, and they are very beautiful as well. That's why I want to try to draw one. And now I'm going to mark where those legs are going to be, those little legs. They are very small and fragile, so I want to be careful not to make them too thick and to look too fake. So I'm using a mechanical pencil with a very thin tip to be able to put in those details and not to make the outline too thick. And here another one. Just need to follow your reference photos class as close as possible. As I said before, you don't have to copy paste it, just give yourself a bit of place for creativity as well. It is important to have fun and enjoy it, not to stress if the outline is matching the reference photo or to be very precise, you just need to enjoy it. Something like this, and a bit those antennas, or how you call them, here as well. Just going to try to make a very fast and light outline. I'm sorry if I'm very bad at speaking and drawing at the same time, but I've never done this before and it's new to me. I'm still trying to get better. But you don't know until you try, right? So that's why I'm doing it now, to get better. And as well to see to hear the feedback from you guys, and as well to see how your drawings turned out, if you're going to do it in the same time with me. But if you're just watching, it's also okay. I am very happy you're interested in seeing me drawing. So I almost finished the last antenna, or how you call it, I really don't know now. hope they're not too big, but I'm going to try to work a bit more on them because I don't like how they look like. I think they're a bit too thick. Just going to try to remake them. I'm really sorry if you're going to hear some sounds from outside, but some neighbors are working on their home and they're using a lot of electric things there, which are very noisy. And I really hope you're not going to be able to see them, but to hear them, but if you're going to hear them, I'm really sorry. I can't stop that. Yes, I think it looks better. It was too thick, and I'm going to try to remake the others as well because I still think they are too thick and they don't look natural. Now, and the last one, which is here, I'm going to try to erase it a bit to remake it again. I really hope my camera is focalizing. If you see my camera moving, I'm really sorry, but I hit it with my head by mistake, and it's going to look like it's an earthquake or something, but I'm just very focused and I just bumped my head into the camera. I'm going to try to be more careful because I don't want the camera to move the whole time. It's not pleasant for you guys and not pleasant for me as well to see it when I'm editing this. Yeah, it looks better now. And now I'm going to use my black pencil and try to darken those up a bit. And this one, it's all very dark, so it doesn't have any highlights, it's just black. So I'm being very careful, I'm taking my time. I don't want to hurry and to make that outline too thick. So as I said before, I'm just taking my time and using, like, I don't do it from one go. I'm just doing it by using very small lines and just by connecting them. I'm going to provide the outline and as well the reference photo in the description of this video. So if you guys want to draw with me together, you can find them there. So you don't have to stress about the outline, you just print it and get to work. I think I need to erase a bit here, and I'm going to use now my Turbo Mono Eraser to erase a bit of the outline because I think I made it too thick and I don't like how it looks like. As you can see here, my eraser wasn't clean and I left a small mark, but it's okay, I'm not going to sell this piece. But that's why I want to tell you guys to be careful when using a Turbo Mono eraser. Be sure it's always clean because you're going to be left with a lot of marks on your paper and they are very hard to erase, sometimes even impossible to erase. That's why please be careful, so don't do the same mistake like me. I'm going to come back with my black pencil now and redo that line I'm trying to make it thinner this time. But I think I need in the end to use it the eraser again, one more time. Yeah, it looks so much better now. But as I said, I need to come one more time with my eraser and to make that thinner again. And try this time not to ruin it. And using my kneadball eraser, I'm going to pick out that pigment from the eraser, the dirt from the eraser. And again, try to make it a bit smoother because it looks a bit chunky, if I can say that. Like not very uniform, just not very uniform. And again, picking it, yeah. I think it looks much better now. And I have a bit of a highlight here, but not much, just at the end of it. Just keep some white of the paper visible to create a highlight. And as well, try to make a small gradient, so press harder here. And towards the end, just lift your pencil from the paper. Like this, and you can see I created a small highlight. Now I'm going to try to work on this one, and this one has a bit more highlights. I'm really angry with myself because I made this mark here, but I'm trying to correct it now with my white pencil by applying a very hard pressure to burnish that black into the paper until you can't see it anymore. And I hope it's going to work, but can make it worse, only better. Applying a very hard pressure. This is also a tip when you're making a mistake to correct it. Like if you dropped your pencil and you left a very dark mark on your paper, just use your white pencil by applying a very hard pressure to cover that up. But first try to erase it with a normal eraser. And if it doesn't work, just use this. And now I'm going to clean my dirt from the pencil with my kneaded eraser, and as you can see it already looks better. It's not totally gone, but it's almost gone, and I'm pleased with how it looks like now. Now I'm going to try to work on this one. I'm going to try to keep it, try to make it from one go. So I'm being very careful. You can tell it already looks better and it's faster as well. And here I have as well a bit of highlight, like the same like here, but a bit bigger. Just try this and this side. Just try to keep this part here white to create a highlight. I did now. Now I'm going to start on the body, and I'm going to use very very small and short strokes like this to create a fluffy effect like this. Using my black pencil, I'm as well trying to follow my outline. So very small and short lines to make it look a bit furry and at the same time fluffy. Trying to follow my reference photo. I don't want to make it too plain, so I'm trying to follow all the curves I seen the reference photo. I need to sharpen my pencil a bit because I need to keep it always sharp, and you guys as well, because you are going to create very small and fine details, and it is very important to keep your pencil sharp in order for you to be able to achieve those small and fine details. Try to create a curve here like this. I don't want my drawing to look too plain, like too flat, so I'm trying to add as many details as possible. And then I as well need to be very careful on those white dots because I don't want to lose them by covering them. I'm going to try to make this a bit higher here. And here a bit more prominent to create a curve effect. Better, and now I'm going to try to make the outline of the white spots again because they are a bit faded. And I'm just using my black pencil. And here inside it's inside the body is very black. So you're not able to see the fluffy furry effect. That's why I'm just going to apply very hard pressure to make it as dark as possible, because I don't see any highlights in my reference photo. Just being very careful not to make those white parts too small, because if I'm going to make them too small, they're going to get lost in all the details, and I want each one of them to be visible. I'm going to use now my white ink pen, this one from Signal, hope you can see it, this one, to make that white a bit brighter, and as well to try to correct it more. Yes, I think it looks better. Not perfect, but better. I'm going to wait for it to try a bit and to come back to it later, and as well going to try to work on this one a bit more like this. And now I'm going to pick up my black pencil and try to work the area around it more. And now that my white gel pen dried a bit, I'm going to work the area around it and to make that white have more of a shape instead of just an oval shape because it looked too flat. And I noticed that the sun came a bit out and my lighting improved a bit, so I'm sorry if you're going to see a lot of lighting changing, a lot of light change, but the sun is getting out of the clouds, going back in, so I think my drawing is going to look brighter sometimes, sometimes darker. That's because of the sun who comes out. Now I'm going to use my white ink pen a bit more. My white gel pen, sorry. To make this line here. And try to work the area around it more. Yeah. I think it looks much better, but I think I went a bit too much with the white. I'm going to cover it a bit here. Try to make the area around it a bit darker. Looks better like this. Now I'm going to try to mark these yellow dots here and try to make a bit of not shadow but just a base layer, just to put them in place and to see where I need to go dark and where I need to keep the white spots untouched. Not going to do the whole body, I'm just going to do this part here, which is going to be the next section I'm going to work on. Now I'm going to go dark to apply a very hard pressure. I know the body part is a bit boring because it's only black and white, but the wings are going to be so beautiful. It has such nice colors, and I can't wait to get to work on them. Now I'm going to work on this little leg here. Like this, I think. It goes down. It has a little spine here like this, it goes like this after, and it has some very very tiny spines here, and a bit it goes up a bit, so this I think be a bit thicker, and I need to come back with my eraser to make this part here a bit thinner. And now I'm going to make it a bit thicker because I erased too much. So it's a lot of dark on the body, so I'm just following my reference photo. I really love how it comes out together, like every part of the body, just by making it darker, how they are connected together and how it starts to look like a butterfly. I'm going to create that fluffy effect again here a bit on the back and a bit here on the back, lower back. And now I'm going to try to make this a bit darker, because I just noticed they look very pale, but they are very dark. Just focusing very much, because I don't want to ruin that outline and to make them too thick again, like I just did. So I need to come back with my white with my eraser to erase them. I'm sorry if I don't sound very excited when I'm talking, but I'm very nervous and I'm trying to focus and in the same time draw and talk in the same time as well. And I'm very excited, but I know it doesn't sound like that, and just that's just because I'm very nervous. My English is not my mother tongue, so I need to translate in my head from Romanian to English. And it takes a while, that's why I need to focus very much. But now, let's get back to the drawing. I'm going to try to work a bit more on this side here. And as well here, to create a very fluffy back of the butterfly. And again applying very short and small lines, by creating very short and small lines. I really think this butterfly is going to be very beautiful, but I really hope it's not going to take too much time. I'm trying to make parts at least made out of 2 hours, that's the maximum. And I think that's the minimum as well. So I think that I'm going to put out parts like 2 hours part one, 2 hours part two, and hopefully 2 hours part three. And that's all. I don't want to make it like 10 parts, because I know it can get boring for you guys. But I really hope you're going to enjoy drawing in the same time with me. I'm very excited to start this project. I want to make a lot of videos of this kind. I don't like to make time lapses, because I can't give all the informations in just such a short time, for example 5 minutes, 7, 9 minutes, and I can't tell my tips in such a short time and my tricks as well. But just by doing a real time, I'm telling everything I'm doing, and you guys can't hear all the tips and tricks. And the fun part is that we can draw together. Okay, I'm mumbling too much. Now back to the drawing. I'm going to just apply some very short and small lines here to make it a bit fluffier. And now I'm going to try to use my slice tool to show you guys how it works like. So I'm just scraping off some pigment from the paper, as you can see here. And here, so I'm applying a very hard pressure to take that pigment off and to create a highlight. And always I'm coming back with my white pencil, which is not very sharp at the moment, so I need to sharpen it now. I'm using a different sharpener from my white pencil. I'm using this one. It is a very small one and it's from M plus R. I hope you can see it. I don't think it's a very known brand, but it's the only pencil sharpener that works with my white pencil. I tried a lot of them, but I always struggled, so I just found this one and kept it. And I always come with my white pencil on top of the slice tool to make that highlight even brighter. As you can see, so I created some highlights very fast just by scraping some pigment from a paper. It saves a lot of time, and as well I love the effect I can create with it. I think this marking, it's not supposed to be here, it's supposed to be here. When I'm making the sketch, I can see all those details very good, but now while I'm looking at my reference photo, I can notice that I've misplaced some areas, but it's never too late because I always correct my sketch after when I start drawing. So it's like I need to make the sketch again. That's why I'm not worrying when I'm making the sketch with my light pad. So I'm using a light pad to make my sketch because it saves me more time and it's faster. But when I start working on the drawing, I always double check it to make sure everything is in the right place. And I'm going to make this area here darker. It kind of starts to look like a bumblebee, but I can assure you it's not a bumblebee for sure, just a monarch butterfly. But they have similar features, that's why it can look like a butterfly, a bumblebee, sorry. I really hope I'm going to get better at this because I'm very bad. But I really enjoy it, guys. It's like having a conversation with you and at the same time drawing. I start to love it. I was very afraid. I was thinking to do that since a long time ago, but I was so afraid I'm going to mumble too much and my English not going to be good enough, or I'm going to block, or I'm not going to know what to say. But I'm going to improve and get better. But for now, I really enjoy drawing together with you guys, and I hope I'm not going to be bored and just move to the next video. It will be such an accomplishment for me to see the drawings you guys made, so to see the results of you drawing together with me. Few years ago, I've never dreamed I'm going to teach people how to draw or other people to follow me in my drawing career, my art career, because 4 years ago I was the one who was watching YouTube videos and I was the one who was learning from other people. But now I think I reached a level where I can teach others as well, so that's why I'm sharing with you guys all I know. And coming back to the drawing, because again I'm talking too much about a lot of things, I'm going to use my white pen to create a white dot here, because it was here, as you saw before, it was here, but I misplaced it, so now I found the right place. And yes, my pen is working finally. Now I'm going to make it here where it belongs. Try not to go too much into the blade, because I'm going to get the dot is going to get lost into the fluffy back, so I'm going to try to keep it here as much as possible. And one more here. Just follow the reference photo good. And I can see that this, I just made it, my slice tool are a bit lighter. So I need to add a bit of the white gel as well. And one more here. And now, because I noticed a dot which is not very prominent and not very light, not very dark, sorry, I'm going to use my slice tool to create it, because it is not very light. It's like a middle shade, middle lighting shading, if I can say that. So it's this one here. You can tell the difference how bright is this and how not very dark, but darker than those. And I need to sharpen my pencil again. I always finish my pencil so fast because I love to work with a sharpened tip of the pencil, so I'm constantly sharpening them. And yeah, of course this means I'm going to finish them faster, but I don't mind. I'd rather finish my pencils faster and be sure that I'm going to achieve very small and fine details and my drawing is going to look very realistic, instead of trying to save my pencil and giving myself a hard time just by trying to create for fine small details with a very dull tip. I know Faber-Castell Polychromos pencil can be pricey, but the money are really worth for the quality you get. I really love them. I used them since 4 years ago and I never changed them because I didn't feel the need to change them. I can do with them whatever I want on the paper. So they are very versatile. And as well, I like working with pencils which have a very hard tip, because I'm applying always a very hard pressure. And if my pencils weren't very hard, I would break them all the time. And that will cost a lot of money to replace them, because if I keep breaking them, I keep sharpening them. And in the end, I keep paying for them because I need to buy new ones. I made this too small and I need to add a bit more white to make it a bit... I have a lapsus. To make it a bit wider, that's the word. To make it a bit wider. For English, please press 1. Okay, and I'm going to add a bit more fluff here. Not very dark, because as I see my reference photo, it's not very dark. It's like a medium highlight. And I noticed as well, it has some very small entrance here. I'm going to use my dark Naples ochre to do it, because it is very yellowish, brownish. So it is one here and a very, very small one here, which you can barely see, but it's there. So I need to make it, because we need to follow the reference photo. And it's connected with a very small line like this. Yeah, I hope you can see it. Going to apply a bit more pressure to make it brighter and more visible. Yeah, better. And now work on this area more and try not to cover those white dots there. And I think I need to use the white ink again, the white gel pen again, to make this a bit wider. Yes, like this, much better. And I need to come here again a bit to darken those areas more a bit, to make that those white dots, those white details, to make them pop out more. I just noticed something here, which I'm going to try to repair. As you can see here, I went a bit too high here, and here this curve is not so visible, and here as well. So I'm trying to cover them now. Something like this, much better. It looks much better. And I noticed they don't have a fluffy effect, so I'm just going to make a very sharp outline. Not worry that it doesn't look like a fluffy or furry effect. So I'm just going to apply very hard pressure. And here as well, I'm going to use my slice tool to make this a bit wider. And a bit closer to this one. Don't combine them, just leave a small line between them to show, to make the effect of, to create a dividing effect so they don't look combined. I need to go a bit higher here. So like this. I'm going to use my kneadable eraser to clean that dirt from inside of it and a bit around it. So you can see here, as I'm very angry at me again, because I always keep seeing it here and here as well. Because I wasn't very careful and I was very nervous, I dropped my pencil. But as I said before, I'm not going to sell this. Because yeah, it's not fair to sell a drawing with a marking. Only if I put it on sale. No, I'm joking, I'm not going to sell it. But it's okay, it's just a study and I want you guys to have fun with me and draw in the same time with me. I'm not doing this with the purpose of selling it. I just want to try this and see if I like it, and as well if you guys like it and would be interested in more kind of this videos, more videos of this kind. Again, for English, please press 1 if you're going to be interested in more videos of this kind, and just to have fun and to try something new, because I don't think I have ever drew a monarch butterfly. I don't think I ever drew a butterfly, like a realistic butterfly. I did once, but it was more like cartoonish effect, it wasn't realistic. But now this Anton keeps bothering me because it's not finished, and I'm going to finish it now to get rid of it, and as well to make this part look more complete. I'm going to try to do it from one go, like this. I'm sorry if I don't talk, but I'm very focused there. I'm even holding my breath when I'm doing this because it's such a meticulous work that if I'm going to do a wrong move, I'm going to ruin it, so I don't want that. but you can of course breathe. You don't have to hold your breath like me. I'm just doing that because I'm very nervous not to ruin it. And as well because I already did a mistake by dropping my pencil from being nervous. I don't want to do more mistakes. But the first one is always the worst, so I'm going to learn to be better at this in the future. Also, it's new for me to follow the reference photo from a bigger distance because I normally have my, for example, my phone here with the reference photo and I'm just comparing it, but now my reference photo is somewhere there on at a more distance than normal, at a larger distance than normal. So it's very confusing for me to do it, but I can do it other way because if I'm going to put my phone too close to my camera, I'm going to the electric field is going to create some weird movements on my camera, and I don't want that, so I just need to work like this. Now I'm going to look for some highlights. Maybe I see. I noticed here I went a bit too far, so I need to make some highlights here. And as well, I see some highlights here. Not very strong highlights, but they are highlights. They are still highlights, so I still need to create to render them. I can't ignore them because this is what makes a drawing look very realistic. It's the small details. And I think I'm going to work a bit more here because I noticed I wasn't very precise. To go here up a bit like this. Almost there, the shape. And I think the woman from upstairs had a brilliant idea to start cleaning or moving furniture. Of course, right now when I'm trying to film my first real-time video. So, yeah, lucky me. But I can't stop because of her. So I'm really sorry if you're going to hear somebody fighting with their furniture. But it's from the woman upstairs. And now I'm going to use my dark indigo for this little leg here because I noticed it's made out of dark indigo, it's not black and white, so I'm going to add a bit of color here. I need to sharpen my pencil. And as well try to create an outline here. Again, a very small spine here. It's not on the photo, but in here a bit. They are not in the reference photo, but I know they have those. And I want to create a bit of more realistic effects, not just very plain. So I'm adding a bit of some spines, or how you call them, I really don't know. Also a very small joint here I see. So I'm, instead of using a white pencil to create the highlight here, I'm just using the, how you call it, I have a lapsus again. So instead of using a white pencil to to create a highlight here, I'm just working around it. So I'm just applying a dark color around it to isolate this highlight and create a highlight effect. But this is a little joint here. And here it's more darkness. I'm going to try to isolate it and to apply a darker pressure here. The small spine here. And another small joint here, I can see. But here it's very dark, so I'm just going to apply a very hard pressure to finish that little leg. And I noticed a swell. I missed a highlight here. It is a very bright highlight, and I'm going to use my white pencil to create it by applying a very hard pressure. Like this, I'm going to come back with my black pencil to try to work around that area a bit and to correct it just by applying a very hard pressure. As you can see, I'm making it look more defined. So it's so hard working on such a small area, because those details are so tiny and so fragile. If you're going to use too much pressure or go too high and or too low, you're going to ruin the small details. So I need to be very careful. But I can notice a bit of dark naples here. I'm going to add a fast base layer here by using the dark naples to create a base layer, as I said before. And now I'm going to try to recreate those white dots. I don't want to make them 100% the same like in the reference photo, because I'm not going to be able to do that, but I want to make them look as close as possible to them. One here, very big one here, again a quite big one here, one here, here as well, one here as well, here, here. As you can see, they are in a totally different place than those. But I'm trying to correct them now. And one here. And one here, but I need to use my white gel pen for that, because it is a bit higher. It's like this. And I'm going to try to... Yes, like this. And I think that's all of it. And I'm going to start working on this side and try to leave that dark naples ochre color still visible through the white one, because that's like a base layer, so I want to be able to see it through my dark pencil. So I'm applying a very light pressure and try not to cover that whole area with black. I want that area to still be able to be seen. So I'm applying a very light pressure and working in layers. something like this. They also notice some of them, they have a dark Naples color, they're not white. For example, this one here, and this one here, and I want to do it now to be sure I don't forget them. And as well, this one here, this one just half of it. And I think that's all. Now I'm going to come back with my black pencil and to try to work on around those areas. And I just noticed a highlight here, so it's from here. I'm going to preserve it by just by drawing around it. And here, like this. And as well one here. So I'm trying to make sure I'm not going to cover that area up. And now I'm going to work between those white dots. With a very light layer, and don't apply a very hard pressure. Just being very careful not to go too much into the white dots and to erase them from the body. But in case I'm going to erase some of them by mistake, I'm going to come back with my white gel pen and remake them. But for now, we just need to draw around them and to make sure we're going to keep the shape of the highlight for later when we are going to work on that area, and to let our eye know that that's a highlight and you don't have to cover it. Like this, as you can see, I just left this part. I left it untouched because I want to come back later and work on it. But for now, I'm just going to apply a very hard pressure to add some finishing touches to that, to the body. And again here on the back, very small and short lines to create the fluffy effect. Kind of like Bumblebee, as I said before. They have the same kind of body, like very fluffy. So I'm trying to make sure I'm keeping that effect. But for now, I'm going to apply very hard pressure. Because it's very dark, the body, so I don't see any highlights. That's why I'm applying a very hard pressure. But still, you need to be very careful not to go too much into the white areas, and as well not to get lost in all those details. Just take your time, take it easy. Nobody's hurrying us to do it. Just need to take our time and have fun. That's very important when you're drawing. Drawing is not about being stressed and not enjoying the progress. You need to always have fun and give yourself as much time as you need. And don't try to finish a drawing in one day. This is only going to make it worse, and it is only going to give you more stress. You're not going to enjoy it in the end. And it's not good. I'm always giving myself as much time as I need. I never finish a drawing in one day. So that's why I really hope you're not going to get bored if this video is going to be too long. Because I'm a very slow drawer. I'm kind of a bit, I'm also a bit of an overblender. Sometimes I'm even blending too much and I'm ruining the drawing. So sometimes you need to know when to stop, but in my case I don't know when to stop, and sometimes I'm doing too much and I'm giving myself more work because I need to undo it and to try to make it look less overworked. So that's why now I want to take my time and to do this drawing as in my pace, as fast as I can, but not like done. I want to make it like followable, if I can say that. As you can see here, I kept my base layer, but it's not very visible anymore. And now I'm going to come back with my dark Naples ochre and to add a bit of a hard pressure to make it more visible. Now I'm going to work on these areas. But here is everything black, so I don't have to worry about base layers. Just this highlight here. Here also, just trying to work between those outlines of the white dots. And here as well, trying to keep that. It has a leg here, and I'm going to try to leave it untouched. Now I'm going to work more on this area because I noticed I made this part a bit too small and it is a bit fatter, if I can say this. He's a bit wider here, and I'm going to try to create a bit of a fluff effect here as well, because I don't have that in my reference photo, but I think it will look better like this. So I'm going to create a fluff effect like this. And here as well, I want to create a fluff effect and make this part a bit wider. So again, I'm using short and small lines to achieve that effect. And I'm holding my pencil as close as possible from the tip. You always should do that when you are working on very small and fine details, and as well when you're applying a very hard pressure, because you are going to hold your pencil too far from the tip, you won't be able to apply that very hard pressure, and as well you won't be able to create that fine and small line, because you won't have a lot of control of the pencil by holding it too far. That's why I need to hold it as close as possible from the tip as you can to control it better and create that those fine and small details. I'm going to apply here a bit of medium pressure because I want to create a highlight, and I'm not going to make it black to cover it. I want to work in layers, so I'm going to build my layers up until I achieve the brightness I want or the darkness I want. But for this part, I'm just going to make it a bit lighter from the rest. So I'm applying a quite of hard pressure, because it is not a highlight like you have here, we have here. It's more like between here and here. So I don't want it to, I don't want to erase it for good. I want to make it visible, but in the same time not too visible, if I can say so. That's why I'm applying quite of a bit pressure. I'm trying not to erase those parts. I need to come back to them anyway soon to remake some details, but I still want to have the basic shape, so I'm being very careful not to go too much with my pencil into them. And if you can notice, the sun is gone, because my video quality, my video lighting is darker now. That's because it's very cloudy here now in Belgium, and it's 2 o'clock, so soon it's going to get dark. So I'm trying to finish this a bit faster to be able to film while still light outside, because I don't like very much to work on the lamp light. I prefer using the natural light, so still have a bit of light today, so enough time. But I think I'm going to film today just the body, and I'm going to call it the part one, and I'm going to continue another day with the rest. But for now, just work on that highlight. I'm going to use my slice tool to recreate some highlights I just lost. I see here a small highlight which comes from here and goes all the way here. I'm going to use my white pencil to brighten that up a bit. Another one, a stronger highlight here. So I'm going to make it lighter. Another one here. I'm going to use my dark naples to make it, to color it, because it is not white, it's that color. I'm going to use my black pencil again to refine this highlight here. And I see one more highlight here, and it is as well same color, dark naples. I'm going to color it. Another last highlight is here and here as well. So I'm going to leave those white because they are white. And I see some very, very small highlights here. I think it's kind of a pollen from the flower. It's not actually a highlight, but I think it looks cool if you make them. And here a bit of pollen as well, here a bit as well, another small highlight here, here. I'm going to come back with my black pencil and try to refine those edges a bit. And sorry, I forgot to speak again. Still very focused. And this goes here as well a bit, I think so. Yes, like this. I'm just applying a very light pressure. And now I'm applying a darker pressure. And I think I need to move this leg a bit lower, so I'm going to erase it now. Going to erase it now and move it a bit lower because I noticed I made it a bit too high. I'm going to change it here. Much better like this. And as well, this make this a bit more prominent. And this one as well. And this one as well. I'm going to add some more highlights here because I don't want this little leg to get lost into the body. So I'm going to use my slice tool. Trying to find a good place on my camera. Sorry if it keeps moving. But now I'm going to darken this area up a bit. And here as well. We're not going to work on that those areas now, but I'm just going to mark them. Try to add a bit more darkness here and here between those. And I noticed here a bit of black, but I'm just going to mark it, not going to work on it now. And I just noticed again, I need to move also one of those highlights lower, not this one, but this one here. I missed this highlight, so I need to create it now. As well, I need to combine those two because they weren't combined in the reference photo. And they are dark Naples color, so they are not white. And now I'm going to use my black pencil again. To create some darkness here. And here. I know it looks very black, but it's the same in the reference photo. It is very black. The body is very black. We're going to have more fun on the wings. It's much more color there. Going to do this little leg as well. It is very light. And I'm going to use the dark indigo. It is very light. And here as well, it has like a rounded shape, not a very pointy. So I'm going to change it. So it's something like this. I'm going to use my white pencil to correct that area a bit. Okay, it looks much better now. I'm going to use it as well a bit on the leg to burnish that dark indigo a bit. And to work that area around it a bit as well. And I think the body is done. I don't see anything I missed in the reference photo. I think I followed everything as close as possible and as better as possible. I want to repeat that I don't want to copy paste it. I want to give my creativity a bit of space and to use it as well. We're not doing this drawing to I'm not doing this drawing to sell it or to copy paste the photo. I just want to draw together with you guys and to share with you my tips and tricks and to have a nice time together, and as well to try this kind of video for the first time. So please let me know in the comments below if you liked it, and if you like to see more videos of this kind. I'm going to continue with this anyway, so I'm going to create a part 2 and I think part 3 as well. I don't think I can finish it in part 2, but I really hope you're going to enjoy it and you're not going to get bored. It's going to be quite a long video, but that's what you get if you want to film a real-time video. But if you survived so far in the video, thank you for watching, and have a nice day wherever you are, and see you in the next one. Bye guys!